In this video, we are going to learn the difference between the Boolean variant and a dropdown variant. We will learn how to take our existing variant set and completely convert it to Boolean. If you're interested to learn more about how we created our dropdown variant set, make sure to watch our part 1 tutorial. Now, let's learn the difference in 6 easy steps. Step 1. Another thing to keep in mind is we have this dropdown. So if I go ahead and try to open it, you see the dropdown is a bit larger. So this is one easy way for you to assign values as variants. If you don't want that, if you don't want to click on the dropdown, and if you want each percentage to be turned into a toggle, you can actually create your variants in a different way. Instead of actually clicking on your bar chart and only giving it property, which is called percentage, you can break this down into 10 different properties and rename the properties as percentage values, which means that if I now click here, instead of actually having it a dropdown, you would have all of these as toggles. So what I would do is I would just rename this to bar chart dropdown, showcasing that this is one way for you to actually organize your variants. I'm going to click outside and try to drag this. Again, this is one of the bar charts that we organized as our variant. What you can do is hold option on your keyboard, click and drag your master component. And now this one bar chart, instead of actually drop down, I would just now choose Boolean. So for us to basically see the difference, all I have to do is click on the master bar chart, which is Boolean, and go on the percentage and just click the minus. If you click the minus, and if we take a look at the left hand side, we see that everything is now being reset to default. However, if we click at the drop down version, you see that we already renamed all of these. So the way that the Boolean works, all we have to do is now, instead of going and selecting one property at a time and going and editing the value, we would create 11 different variant property. So let's just go ahead and do that. Here we would click on our bar chart, and as you can see, we have one default property one. We can double click on that, and then we can rename this as 0%. And now all we need to do is go on that property again. Here you see on the top side we have the word property. As soon as you hover over that, we have that plus tiny icon appearing. I actually resized this panel, so your panel might be different. So you can hover over that property and you would see that plus icon appearing. The reason I resized that because I want to explore that variant side. So as soon as you hover over that properties, you can now click plus and you have 4 options to choose from. I already explored all the different options in a 20-minute video on my YouTube channel called Component Properties. So if you're interested to learn about exposed nested instances, you can also watch that video. Step 2. In this example, we are only going to explore the variant option because this is the only property we care about in this video. But if you're interested to learn more about the other options, make sure to watch that video. But for now, we would just basically click the variant. And then as you can see, Figma tells us to give it a property name. So here we would just give it 10%. We don't care about the value because we have to fix the value later on. So we would click create. And then as you can see right now, we have 2 variant properties, which is again a 0% and a 10%. So I have to repeat that process 9 more times to create until 100%. And the process is hovering over the properties, clicking the plus, adding a variant, and then renaming the property again every time 10% up. Here we have now 20%. So I would go ahead and fast forward that. Step 3. And as you can see, we created 11 different variant properties all the way from 0% to 100%. However, if I click and drag one of these outside, I'm selecting an instance, which is the Boolean version. And on the right hand side, I don't have the option to basically select all of these. And also Figma tells me that there are conflicting properties. So how can we resolve that issue? Step 4. So the way we'd fix that is we need to give all of these a true and false value, which means that for the first one, which is 0%, we want to make sure that the 0% property instead of default is actually set to true. Again, it is really important to actually type it exactly this way as true, because if you don't type it that way, Figma is not going to create a toggle for you. So here, as soon as you add true to your first variant property and you click outside, and then if we go ahead and select the Boolean version, right now we see that our value has changed from default to true, but Figma really didn't pick up that version, which means it really didn't turn it into a Boolean toggle. So how can we achieve that and fix this instead of having it as default and true? We do want this to be a Boolean. All I have to do is now click on my master one and click on the first one. And then as you can see, the 0% is true. And all I need to do is give false for all the other properties, which means I only select the first variant and I only give it one true value, and all the other properties, I will leave them as false. So if I go ahead and quickly rename all of these to false, this is how our variant looks like, which means that for the first one, which is 0%, we do want to make sure that the first one is set to true and all of these are set to false. And we have to repeat that all the way when it comes to the 10%. Here, as soon as I click 10%, you see everything is resetted back to default, which means now on the 10%, I have to give the 10% the true value and all of them a false value. And I have to repeat that for all of this. But as you can see, it is a bit of a time consuming process if I have to constantly click on the variant, give this true and reset everything to false, go back to the other one, only give the first one 0% a true, reset everything to false. Is there a way for us to actually bulk rename these? And the answer is yes. Step 5. So in order for us to speed up the process, all we have to do is select everything on the variant. Again, if you select the entire thing, it would select the parent component, and we don't want that. So make sure to only select the nested variants, not the master component, because if you do that, you don't have the ability to rename your variant. So it is really important to only select the variant inside your master component. And by doing that, now I have the ability to bulk rename them. As you can see, all of these are set to default. Because I have selected all of them, I can actually go ahead and rename them one by one to false. This way the false value gets applied to all of them in a bulk way. So I have all of them selected, and I would go ahead and give this false one at a time to all of these. And by doing that, I make sure that all of the variant properties that I selected have the initial false value. Again, if you take a look at the left hand side here, you see that even the layer panel is being renamed. We don't care about the layer panel because it is not human readable. So what I would do is I would close that, because we don't care about the layer panel. We do care about the actual variant panel. So now if I go ahead and select all of them, we know that all of them are now set to false. So all I have to do is select one of them, which is 0%, and only give true to only 0% variant property. Also, I have to pay attention that all the other ones need to be false. So I should not touch 10% all the way to 100%. I only need to change the 0%, and I have to make sure to rename it exactly like true, like that. So now we have to repeat the same process. We would just select the 10% and only rename the 10% to true, leave everything else to false. Same thing, we would just select the 20%, only go to the 20%, give this to true, and leave everything else as false. So I would go ahead and repeat that multiple times all the way to the 100%, and I would go ahead and fast forward. Step 6. Now, if I go ahead and select the bar chart, now we see that our values, instead of being default, is exactly being renamed to false and true. And you have to make sure that exactly it is renamed this way for the Boolean variant to work, which means if I have to now compare the Boolean version of our variant to our dropdown version, you see a big difference. Even though they are built identical here, there is nothing changed. All we changed was the variant and how they're structured. And as you can see, the dropdown version, we have something called the percentage. And if we click that, we have the ability to filter, and then as you can see, our variants get updated. However, if I click on the Boolean, instead of having this as a drop down, I have a very nice toggle to work with here. As soon as I click 60%, it actually updates to 60%, 80%, 20%, and as you can see, this is so much easier to work with. If I click on the drop down, you no longer have to click, and then you see it is a bit of a long drop down, so you have to kind of scroll, select that. Both approach is correct. It always comes down to your preference on which one do you like more. Do you like the Boolean version, so you only click once and you see all the properties listed that way and you have everything as a toggle, or would you like to have everything as a drop down to filter between your variants that way? Don't forget to like and subscribe for more design tips and tutorials, and let me know what you think in the comments down below.